viewers, welcome to CarView. Today we have with us the rival of Tata Punch and Nissan Magnite, the Renault Kiger. The car looks very sporty and aggressive from the front. It has very attractive DRLs and LED headlamps. This is the Renault logo with stylish grills.
It comes with two engine variants, 1-liter turbocharged engine which produces 100 bhp power and 1-liter energy engine which produces 70 bhp power.
The key looks very nice and is very handy and lightweight. It has four options: lock, unlock, boot open and cabin lights. The panel gap is minimum and we have the top model RXZ badging here. Then we have the ORVM's piano black, which is electrically adjustable, retractable and foldable. The handles are body colored. We also get roof railings. The overall look is very sporty. Coming to the wheels, we have 16-inch diamond cut alloy wheels with the tire profile 195/60R16. The spoilers along with the complete rear look is very attractive. The ground clearance is 205 mm and the wheelbase is 2500 mm. We have this very attractive C-shaped LED tail lights. This enhances the overall look of the car. We also have halogen indicators. We could have had LED indicators instead of this. We have the Renault logo. And we have this camera embedded between the logo, which is actually looking very nice. And then we have the defoggers and wipers along with a washer. The grey colored skid plates enhances the overall sportiness of the car. And you also get sharp fin antenna. Kiger comes with a boot space of 405 liters, which can be extended by folding the seats 60-40, and it extends up to 879 liters. The boot floor is quite deep, so it will be a little uncomfortable in loading and unloading things inside. Let's move inside the car.
Also, the key comes with a smart feature. The car gets unlocked automatically if the key is near the car and gets locked if it's away.
Here is the speaker. You have different window and ORVM controls. The material of the door is hard plastic. The door handle comes with a piano black finish. The door thud gives a sign of a decent build quality. The steering is leather wrapped and quality is quite good. The center console comes with an armrest and a storage space inside. You have a storage space here as well. The complete center area looks average. Here we have three modes. It has normal mode, eco mode, and sports mode. The gear knob quality is nice according to the price range. Here we have the start stop button. It indicates if any of the doors of the car are open. You get basic infotainment control things like volume up, volume down, call, accept and reject, or back, source, etc. The car does not come with cruise controls. You do not get wireless charging. You can opt for it in accessories if you want. You have USB charging here. You have different AC and fan controls in this section. Here we have an 8-inch infotainment system. And the dashboard is of hard plastic quality. Although I was quite impressed by the exterior of the car, the interior could have been better. This is the maximum angle at which the door can open. There's ample space inside the car, that is not at all a problem. You can see the head space, leg space, and thigh support. Thigh support could have been a little better. It has two headrests, two cup holders, and a little more space here. Because the floor is flat, so three people can accommodate easily. There we have the AC vents, and also we get charging point at the bottom.